بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اوكي. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we are talking about a very important topic, although very basic, but it's a very important topic. صراحة لاحظنا بعض النواب يعني they don't know about these principles, although they do a good technique, good playing technique, but they don't know what is the idea behind. That's why we choose to talk about this concept. It is about plating techniques, basic principles and techniques of plate fixation. Presented by me, Dr. Ahmed Sadeh. Let us just talk about, or just a refreshment about the bone healing biology. As you know, we have two types of bone healing. The primary bone healing, which occur in absolute rigid stability through the cutting cone model. The other one is the secondary bone healing, which occurs in the relative stability. Relative stability. الكلام ده مهم when you are choosing the type of fixation technique. Type of fixation. Okay. The direct primary healing as a just consider it occurs through the cutting cones. Cutting cones. Okay. And the secondary or indirect one occurs through the callus formation. The steps of the callus formation, as you know. Okay, for relative stability, we choose IM nailing, X-fix, cast, and bridging plate. Bridging plate. Consider this, we'll talk in a minute. In absolute stability, we use either lag screw, plus or minus plate, and compression plate. Okay. To be honest, most of fixations probably involve components of both types. يعني ما نلقى healing of just pure primary or pure secondary. Both of them do occur at the same time, but in different percentage. مش كده هنقول mainly primary healing. يعني حتى الـ primary healing that occurs through cutting cone لو عملنا compression plate you will find a bit careless, a bit careless. اشكال يكون mixed type but with higher percentage of primary bone healing. Now let us talk about the plate. Biomechanics in a very important concept which is the bending stiffness. Bending stiffness. The bending stiffness is proportional to the thickness or height of the plate. The height of the plate. Okay. It equals to the base of the blade, in other words, the number of screws, times the height to power third. Okay. Very important. Very important, height of the plate, the thickness of the plate. So, if there is unstable construct, it is almost impossible to do a rigid fixation, almost impossible. That once occur in severe comminution, if there is bone loss, poor bone quality, or poor technique. Poor technique also sometimes give unstable construct. Bone loss or fracture gap, they do what? It will allow bending of plate with applied load. The consequence will be fatigue failure. فتيك فيلير، عشان كده احنا هنا مقولة احفظوها كده يعني. It is a hurry between bone healing or fracture healing and failure of fixation. It is a hurry. That's why we say every now and then we say bone protect plate. حاجة غريبة، نحن نعمل plating fixation to allow healing of the bone. If this healing does not occur, definitely failure will do occur. What we call fatigue failure. عشان كده bone protect plate. This is a concept. حاجة تحطها في بالكم. Okay. So what is fatigue failure? Well, even stable construct may fail from fatigue if the fracture does not heal due to biological reason. That's why we said bone protect plate. Okay, this is an obvious example. Now, what are the function of the plates? What are the function of the plate or the fixation in general? Interfragmentary screw or compression. The last lecture, the previous lecture, Mr. Ahmed Bashambi Jazallah here talk about it and explain and explore a lot of principles about it. It is not just to put in a screw. We'll touch in a minute, just a refreshment. Then, when you use plate to fix a fracture, it has a lot of functions. Although the same plate, it has a lot of function. In one fracture, it could be neutralization, that we call neutralization plate. In other, we use as a buttress plate. In others, we use as a bridging plate. Sometimes we use as a tension band, which is dying now, honestly, but still function of plate. And what is well known is compression. Compression and locked plate. This is a newer era, locking plate. So although you use the same plate, it differs in the function according to the fracture geometry and the technique you are using it. So it is a principle. It is a principle. It is not just a device. Put this in mind. Put this in your mind. It is a principle. Okay? So the lag screw fixation, as Mr. Ahmed Bashandi talked last lecture, you do like that. It should be perpendicular to the fracture. Why? And you do over drilling hole, etc. There are two types of technique, yeah, two techniques to do lagging, either to over drill the previous one, what we call the hole, or use a lag screw itself, the fully threaded one and the partially threaded one. I think Mr. Hagashan will talk about it. So what is the most important now? If you use a lag screw plus plate, this we call neutralization plate. Neutralization plate. Okay. This is about lag screw. This one, neutralization plate. If you use here, this one, lag screw, and you put a plate, this will be neutralization plate. Yeah. Sorry? Mister? Okay, let's continue. So this neutralization plate, it is a protection plate. It is used to protect this screw. Okay, the forces come through the bore and goes through the plate down here and save the area around the lug screw. And this will do the fixation. Okay, and this protect from almost all forces around here. Bending forces, shearing forces, and even torsion. So neutralization plate is a protection plate. Okay, it's obvious here. This is a lug screw, and this is the neutralization plate. If we don't use lug screw, this will be a compression or a positional plate. This is a hint for coming. The other thing is the buttress plate or anti-glide plate. We'll see the difference in a minute. This holds the bone up to resist mostly the shearing forces. Mostly the shearing forces during axial load. Okay. So if you use a plate as a buttress, commonly a shabab will distal radius, huh? And proximal tibia. It is just to hold the fracture in its position as a buttress. Buttress in Arabic means du'ama or sannada. Okay. So it should be pre-contoured. Pre-contoured. كلمه دي مفصليه. Should be pre-contoured. Do your reduction of the fracture, then put the plate as a buttress. Just. Okay, like this. The order of fixation will be to fix, to do the reduction, then to fix the distal first, distal screws third. You can temporarily fix this with scale wires. Okay. Then you put the screw. Then you first fix the bottom screws. Okay. Then you fix the two, the top two partially threaded or cannulated screws. And finally, we fix this one. This is a buttress technique. This is a buttress technique. يا شباب احفظوا الحاجة دي مهمة. ما في زول في البطرس ليه تمشي يثبت لنا دي الأول حاجة. Never. Never ever do this. Please. Huh? What is the anti-glide blade? It's the same. The same concept. The only difference عشان ما نشغلكم بالكلام كتير. The only difference is that the buttress in the metaphyseal region and the anti-glide in the diaphyseal region, but the same to prevent the gliding. That's where anti-glide, the gliding of this segment over this segment. Okay, so this will buttress the proximal, the same effect. This is a stable construct. What about the bridging blade? The bridging blade, if there is a comminution in the fracture side. So we fix a plate to bypass this comminution area. To bypass this comminution area. Okay. So this is unstable construct. So the same plate here will be unstable construct. Unstable construct. Will delay the weight bearing. It will delay the weight bearing. Okay. Okay. Generally speaking, حاجة مهمة جدا. Avoid soft tissue disruption at the fracture to maintain blood supply. الأيم بتاعها is to maintain the length, rotation, and axial alignment. Just يعني to keep the bone as it is, and the biology will give the rest. That's its function. شكل اسمه bridging. pigeon blood. And these are examples. What about tension band? يا شباب tension band كتير منكم احنا زمان كنا ذات نفهم كده نفهم انه tension band is K wire plus the tension band. I mean the circular wire. It is not. Tension band is a concept. Tension band is a concept rather than a special device, okay? Okay? It is a concept when we use to fix a fracture on its tensile side. نحن مستر حبشان تتكلم يبقى على الحاجة. عندنا compressive side and عندنا tensile side. When we put an implant in the tensile side, the aim is to convert the tension forces into compressive forces. Most of the time, this will be around the joint. And the striking examples are the olecranon. كلكم تعرفون the olecranon. بنعمل له tension band والcirculage wire. K wires والtension والcirculage wire. The other one is this. When we use a plate in the lateral aspect of the proximal femur, except DHS, dynamic hip surgery, because this is a lat, this is a different mechanism. If you use LCP, lock plate, or this one, which is dying, that's why I said this dying now, it is tension band. Tension band plate, okay? The tension band theory, it will convert the tensile forces into compressive forces. That's it. That's what you want to know about it. Okay, and this is the striking example you all know. Now, we will talk about the compression plate. The compression plate. You will use and compress transverse or oblique fractures. Don't use this in spiral or comminution. The alter plate, the spiral or comminution fracture, it will not be compression plate. It will not be compression plate. Okay? It will be either bridging plate, positional plate. It will never be compression plate. This is principle. Okay. When we use a compression plate, if we can't use leg swallow, and we want to exert or to do compression across the fracture site. Historically, كان بيعمل الحاجة دي كيف؟ هسه كلهم تعرفوا حاجة واحدة، كلنا بنعرف حاجة واحدة. لكن هيستوريكلي اول ما بدوا يعملوا الحاجه دي كان بيعملوا بري بند. هنشوف هسه بيعملوا بري بندنج للبليت when you apply by its compression to the fracture site it will do compression I mean when you compress on the bone surface it will compress the fracture site. الحاجه الثانيه بيعملوا external compression device اسمه تنشنر شفناه ولكن ما اشتغلنا عليه. وآخر حاجة بيل كومن ناو we use a compression plate اللي اسمها DCP. DCP DCP الاسم نوع يسار كويس DCP هنعرف اسم. So what is compression? It is a fundamental concept critical for primary bone healing. Okay. Critical for primary bone healing. It could be achieved through leg screw or plating technique. Plating technique. The pre-bend plate, كنا نتكلم عنها. لاحظوا هنا يعني شوية معوجة. دي pre-bend technique كنا نتكلم عنها. when you stretch it like in this way, it will drag the fracture here, the distal fragment to the proximal fragment and do compression in the fracture site. That's what you want to know. This is an old technique. Okay. The other one, when you use the tensioner, you apply the plate to the distal fragment, then you use the tensioner to tension, to compress, I mean, the fracture side. Then you fix the proximal fragment. الحاجة دي historically يعني كانوا بيعملوها زمان لأن البليت كان الهول بتاع is just circular. Just circular. Okay. Either in this one or the previous one. The previous one. Circular. Nowadays, we use dynamic compression plate. DCP. Okay. عشان يا شباب لو جابوا لكم بليت الهول بتاعتها ما اوفل it is not an oval this will not be dynamic compression plate this will not be DCP okay DCP per se should the screw holes be oval okay being oval to do compression plate اتفقنا يا شباب okay So how to do compression? شنو هو the principle, the technique? How to do compression? I think you all know. You do a drilling in the eccentric side of the hole. يعني away from the fracture side. Away from the fracture side. Okay. If you want to do compression here, you do fixation in one side as usual and then you do compression by doing a hole in the eccentric one that is away from the fracture side when you tighten the screw it will compress the fracture side here افضل بطريقه المعمولات افضل to go distal I mean further ليه لانه بتديك من نفسك مساحه لو شفت انه لسه في gap you do another one here and then you come here you can still do compression okay but if you did the nearest one to the fracture side خلاص you lose your chance you lose your chance nowadays we do compression by here and here and classically you fix one side and do compression from the other side okay you'll see in a minute as you see, dynamic compression plate, the DCP, the compression applied via the oval holes and eccentric drilling. Okay, this one. Okay. الحاجة اللي عندها عيوب هشوف اللي قدام وانا اقارن بين الكمبريشن بليت واللوك بليت. Forces. Bone screw plate relationship. And bone via compression. This will be applied now. And a compression plate via bone plate friction. Okay. And literally the friction between the plate and the bone. هنعرف اللي قدام أهمية الكلام ده شنو. And the friction through the screw. Okay, these are the three forces pairing when you are doing plating technique, especially the compression one. But حاجة تانية مهمة, the screw nearer to the fracture side, the rectangular fracture side, those I mean those ones, those screws. These faces the most forces. This will take the most forces. I'm going thus. This will take more force than this, and this more than this. Okay? And vice versa. كلام ده مهم، كلام ده مهم جدا جدا، هنعرف بعد شوية ايه الكلام. عشان يكون عندي stable construct number of screws in other words vortices should be adequate. Should be adequate. Adequate دي الكلام اللي بنقول لكم يعني distal radius sorry radius ulna هيومرس. الحاجات دي احفظوها باي هارت يا شباب. كلامنا اتعمل في البايوميكانيك لابس، بايوميكانيك لابس، وطلعوا بالريزلتس دي. انت عشان يكون عندك ستيبل كونستراكت لابد اتليست ذا مينيمم، احنا بنتكلم عن مينيمم الفور ار ريديوس عملنا، ات شود بي اتليست 3 screws in each side. 3 screws in each side. I'm talking about 5 to 6 vortices. In the humerus should be 4. 3D to children. But it should be 4. I'm talking about 8 vortices. Okay. Free لو كان distal distal humeral fracture في الأدلتس I will accept. Okay. Tibia must be 4. That means 8 cortices and the femur will be minimal. الكلام ده شنو؟ لأنه لو عملت 2 مثلا هنا 2 this screw will take a huge amount of force and this one will take a bit smaller and definitely will fail. لكن الثالث ده الامن اللي لانه يشيل معاهم اللود. دي الفكره كلها الكلام اللي بنعمله. اوكي. جبال اتكلمنا عنه the main في neutralization plate. The main is the lag screw, and I do the neutralization plate to protect or to divert the forces from the screw area. The lag screw should be perpendicular to the forces. Lacking, if I can do a lag screw through the plate, it will be better. It will be better. How? If the fracture side, if the screw through the hole of the plate will be perpendicular to the fracture side, as you see here. And this will be lag screw through the plate. Lag screw through the plate. Then the lag screw, no? Will do dual function. Will do dual function. Okay. Here, this will be compression plate. And at the same time, it will do neutralization to this one. Okay. Okay. And this is a dual function. طيب. اخر حاجه في الكومبريشن عشان الحاجه اللي هنستفيد منها لقدام في the new era دي الكلاسيكال دي سي بي. اتفقنا ان دي سي بي is dynamic compression plate. الهوست بتاعي يكون اوفل عشان I can do compression through this. لو كان دي سيركولر this will be compression plate. It will not be, sorry, Khalid. it will not be, if this circular, it will not be DCP. It will be compression plate only if I use it as a compression technique. I'm talking about technique. If it is oval, it will be DCP. Tafagna? It will be DCP, dynamic compression plate. Also, if I use it for compression plate in a transverse or low oblique fractures, okay? And use the technique of compression plate. Okay. عيوبة شنو نحن دي شفناها؟ عيوبة الكلام اللي قلناه قبل شوية. The forces between the surface of the plate and the bone, surface of the bone, it will be a huge amount of force. Huge amount of force, pressure. زي ما حنشوف بعد شوية, this will decrease the blood supply in the periosteum. The periosteum. Okay. Although it is stiff, but unfortunately, biomechanically, but unfortunately has a drawback, which is decreasing the blood supply through the prostate. So they invent a new one, which is with a new plate, which we call low contact dynamic compression plate, LCDCP. LCDCP. Here the same plate, لكن بس تحت تلقوا فيها فراغات اللي هي اللي شفتوها دي, بس عشان شنو؟ Q allow some areas for blood supply of the periosteum. That's it. This is strong, by the way. The same. Okay, these areas will not decrease the stiffness of the plate compared to this one. Okay? أنا هو كلام عن height مش كنا. يبقى شو ما بيني الستيفنس بيني شنو؟ depends mostly on the thickness, the height of the plate. So it will not reduce the stiffness, okay? في حاجة تانية, the semitubular plate, what is my fibular plate. Fibular plate. Okay? Fibular plate will never be a compression plate. حاجة غريبة مش كده؟ will never be a compression plate. لأن السكرو هوز بتاعته circular. عشان كده commonly when we use semitubular plates we use lag screw عشان تكون لي شنو؟ neutralization plate. Neutralization plate. If I use semitubular plate alone, it will be a positional only. Positional plate. Okay? But the حاجة دي احنا جبناها بس عشان نستفيد منها اللي قدام. Knowledge to compare between locking and compression. Now, the new era about locking plates. Lock. Locking plates. Locking that means lock. The screw head has a thread that locks into the threaded hole in the plate. Okay? يعني المسمار ما بيربط في شنو؟ It's just the bone. It'll be locked into the plate. This will create a fixed angle at each hole. الحاجة دي مهمة. It's very important. هنشوفها هسه. Theoretically eliminates individual screw failure. من النادر جدا, من الصعب بالمناسبة, إن يحصل individual يعني screw واحد يحصل له failure. الحاجة دي common في الكمبريشن بليتس. لكن في اللوك بليت never. لو حصل failure بتطلع كلها. Okay. Plate bone contact is minimal. Almost negligible. Okay. We'll see in a minute. دي الحاجة المهمة. The blocking plate, you must have reduction and compression before you're putting your locked plate. Okay? Before you put your locked plate. تعمل reduction بتاعك. هشوف الكلام ده بعد شوية. زي ما قلنا في البداية، the locking plate increase axial stability as a compression plate. أهميتها it will reduce a lot the possibility of screw failure, individual screw failure. But still, if the biology doesn't go well, I mean healing does not okay, still the plate can fail, can fracture itself. So it is a hurry, as I said earlier, it is a hurry between the fracture healing and the fracture. What are the indications? نحن generally speaking ما نستخدم اللوكينج بليت ساين صح؟ Nowadays it's widely used. Okay. لكن عندنا indications it is a must. I mean ما في مانع تستخدم اللوكينج بليت في اي حته، ما في مانع. لكن في indications it will be a must. يعني it will be a crime if you use a conventional plate. That's the message. Okay. Like what? Osteopenic bones. Osteoporosis and in metaphyseal fractures, okay, metaphyseal fractures, especially near the articular cartilage, and if you used as a bridging blade, أنا أعرف ليه بعد شوية. Bridging blade عشان البيولوجي بس يا شباب. I need healing, okay. طيب, the conventional plate. خلينا نقول دي سي بي، خلينا نقول دي سي بي. اللي بيحصل شنو؟ شايفين التكنيك؟ شنو؟ اكسنتريك. When you tighten, the blade goes that way. Muscle compression. Okay. By the way, I took these slides from the AO site. Yeah? From the here. That's it. دي النقطة اللي بتكلم عنها. The tension or the forces between the plate and the bone surface is a huge shower here. Okay. And it will be increased when the patient puts his load. This will be affected. Immediately the effect will be around the screw. Okay. شوف الفرق. If the lock plate, if we use a lock plate, when I tighten the screw, nothing will happen. Already I tighten here in the plate itself. So nothing will happen here except at the bone. The hole in the bone itself, but the surface will do nothing. This is the difference. Already locked. No more forces, okay? So the load will be only in the cortices through the hole. That's it. That's it. Okay? This is the difference, yeah? And here, nothing. If you tighten the screw, nothing will occur. But if you tighten the screw here, a lot of forces will be between the bone surface and the plate. That's it. Look. This is the standard one, or the conventional plate. Okay? With the load of the patient, the screw will start to move. تخيل, imagine this is osteoporotic bone. هتلقى السكرو طوال طلع. نحط الجسم نعيد تاني مع اللود طوال. This is a failure. Do care with the conventional plates. Let me show the locking plates. What will happen? Already there is a gap. Okay, the screw tightens already, locked in the plate. There is a gap between the plate and the bone. So, this is when you put load, you do only quantities, not all this area. Only in this one, only. Okay. This is what I'm talking, just talked about it. If I use a conventional gate, the pull-out strength of the screw will be individual. يعني عادي سكرو ده يرجع ونقطه حاجه دي يكونوا شفتوها يبقى السكرو ده بيطلع عادي easily with the bending forces with the bending forces سكرو بترجع عادي كان الحاجه دي شبه مستحيله في اللوكينج بلير لان الريزيستنس اريا will be huge هنا ما محتاج هنا السكرو will go up like that pull out في اللوكينج yes like this في اللوكينج The lock screw, when already tightened in the plate, need to go through all this area to be pulled out. And it will not be alone with the others. So it will be difficult. Okay. يعني في قبلها the screw just for the thickness. These are the reacting force. Around the screw, so it is easily will go out, pull out strength. Like a floating plate, need to go all this area to sail and to go out. And because it is already tightened to the plate, it's not easy to go out. It will go all of it, this with this and with this. So, the biomechanical advantages of flock plating, the breakage of the screws to bone is not critical. Late, and the breakage is already in the plate. Hayatania, the preservation of periosteal blood supply. This is very important. Okay. Strength of fixation rely on the fixed angle constructive screw. بليت هشوف هشوف الكلام ده بعد شويه النقطه المهمه دايركم تعرفوها The lock plate act as internal X-fix internal X-fix this دي حاجه اتكلمنا عنها جريرا يعني this is a conventional DCP and this is a low contact DCP okay this compress on the periosteum. Here, there is a gap leaving a small, some area for the periosteum to have its blood supply. I think it's so, the lock plate is more superior than even than the low contact device, okay? The conventional plate, given the friction, yeah? Friction is great. Here always minimal because it is internal expression. Sure. Minimal, negligible. Okay. So the bone is pre-stressed and the periosteum is strangled. Here, nothing. Maybe the angle is stability. The conventional plates, look, the screw. It's fixed nicely here. Okay. And here is already tightened to the plate. So what happened if there is a bending in the gap? What will happen? See? This will be bended like that and the screw will go that way. But here it will be very difficult. Here it will be very difficult because is already tightened in the plate. Look, that's it. Okay. If this occur, it will occur through the plate and not through the screw. بتحصل بتحصل fracture عليه. نجي للكمبريشن تكلمنا عنه قبل في الكمبريشن بليت دي سي بي. Here I can do compression. I'm not talking about the fracture site here. I'm talking about the compression to the plate. Eh? This is okay. See again. This is a fracture site. When I use the screws, it will go like this. Simply, you could open that. Okay. The conventional plate. الحيري شبه مستحيلة شبه مستحيلة في اللوك بليت يا مرجان، أتمنى إن تكون حاضر يا مرجان، أتمنى إن تكون حاضر في اللوك بليت. This is almost impossible. Look, you should do your reduction first. Okay, here I can do reduction through the plate. Can aid, I mean. But in the locking plate, this is locking plate. We'll see in a minute. You should do your reduction first. Then you put your screws. Look, that's another locking plate. Nothing will happen. Screw is very important. You do your anatomical reduction first. Then you put your, apply your lock plate, okay? Like this. You do your reduction, then you put your plate and stabilize your fracture. أرجان أتمنى إنك تكون تذكرتها. في حاجة تانية هذكر بها أرجان، لو مثلا يعني بهزر معه ما عندي عليه حاجة يعني. طيب ده الكلام اللي اتكلمنا عنه. في اللوك بليت you need to reduce the fracture prior to apply locking screws. طيب generally speaking what are the advantages of the lock plate over the conventional one? Number one, force distribution. Force distribution plate لانه عندي جزء من force would be upon the plate itself, not the bone. It will prevent the primary reduction loss and secondary reduction loss. If you do your reduction, the primary reduction, and then you apply your plate, because the tension will be on the plate screw surface, not the bone screw surface. That's why it will prevent the primary and the secondary reduction loss. Okay, primary during your operation and secondary later on. This will okay. Simply like this. It is not an important to do all screws through both cortices for locking plate. ليه؟ لأنه عندي another factor اللي هو plate itself. I can do just one screw and it will be equal. عشان كده احنا بنقول one cortex in a locking equal two cortices in a conventional plate. تمام؟ يعني ده this is locking plate. This equal ده إذا اعتبرناه conventional plate. Sorry يعني from here to there this is locking and this is conventional. This one although is not reaching the far cortex is equal to this if this is conventional. Okay, so it gives more stability. بالضرورة it will improve the percussion stability point as I said earlier and decrease the pull-out strength upon the screws. شفنا الكلام اللي قبل شوية. But there is a large area of resistance. If I want to use nowadays, I use a hybrid fixation. يعني اللوك بليت كلاسيكال لوك بليت يكون جاست لوك سكروز. لكن nowadays بتجوها locked screw اللي هي فيها threaded screw وجنبيها طوالي oval hole as a DCP. دي بنستخدمها what we call hybrid hybrid fixation. دي بنستخدمها to aid the reduction. To aid the reduction. يعني كل مرة الناس بتطور. If you want to do this, you can use for compression, the reduction, and even for lag screw. Lag screw. So to give more stability, more stable construct. Okay. How? You apply here. Normally. Then you apply first the normal, the lag screw, the compression screw. Okay. It will act as a lag, like this. It will help to aid the reduction. Then you apply your locking screws, the lock screw, the conventional or compression screw. You cannot do a compression screw, normal screw, lag screw, after the locking screws. You should do it first, then you put your lag screw. This is wrong. As you saw, this is wrong. This is wrong. If you want to do, you do like that. Lag screw, another vertical screw, another well, then the locking screw. The reverse is incorrect. This one. You put the lock screw and then you put the cortical screws, this is wrong. Okay. This what we call hybrid fixation. I talked already about it. This will combine the benefit of both the conventional and the lock screws. And can use the pre-contour plate. Pre-contour pre-contour as the mesh. اللوك بليت اصلا بتجي بي كنترول اللي هو احنا بنسميها اناتوميكال. That's why it will help the reduction. It will aid the reduction. يعني تظبط الريدكشن عليها باختصار. تمام؟ لانه صعب هي فيري ستيف صعب تعمل لها موديفيكيشن يعني. الدي سي بي والحاجات الثانيه دي ممكن احنا بنعمل لها بري بيندنج. بتعمل الريدكشن وتجي تعمل بيندنج اكوردنجلي. لكن اللوك بليتس تجي اوريدي اناتوميكال بري كنترول. الحاجه دي بتفيدني انا بالريدكشن كويس يعني بظبط الريدكشن عليها تمام ده المقصود بالبري كونتور يا شباب عشان كده قال لك شنو ريديوس ذا بون تو ذا بليت then compress the lag screw to the plate and then apply the lock screws الكلام اللي قلناه قبل شويه اوكي طيب What about the length of a scrap, length of construct? المقصود بشنو length of say, number of screws. Number of screws. The most suitable one, أنا سحبت كلام كتير عشان بيغلقكم. The most suitable one is longer plate with fewer number of screws. بس احفظوا لي دي. باختصار في الطلاق واحدة ما تعمل فيها سكرو واعمل اللي بعديها تمام فوق واحد واعمل الثاني بعد تظبط الريدكشن بتاعك يعني وانت خلاص ظبطت الريدكشن وثبتت التثبيت الاولي خلاص بعد كده تملى الفراغات فوق واحد واعمل واحد This will be more stable okay longer spread is less screws يعني هيك ذا رول 3 سكروز ان 5 كورس يعني شنو؟ سطيت واحد وعملت واحد بس. Avoid too rigid construct. Avoid too rigid construct. ليه؟ For biology. For biology. For biology. For biology. To give or to give some load to the bone. ليه؟ لو احنا قلنا اللوك بليت will act as X fix. X fix is a load sharing. it is not rigid, it is a load sharing. بتبعيرين يعني. Although the space or the distance between the plate and the bone is minimal, نحن عارفين الـ stability في الـ XFX واحدة من الحاجات المهمة فيها the distance between the bar and the surface of the wall, مش كده؟ فهنا دي once in the internal, so this is minimal, more stable. لكن still it is an excess, internal excess. فدي الفكرة بس, دي الفكرة. To aid the healing, to aid the healing. عشان احنا قلنا failure of fixation depends, I mean the, خلينا نقول failure of fixation will occur if the healing is delayed. Bone protected, هذه الكلمة الأولى من شباب. دي الفكرة من الكلام. الآخر حاجة what we call percutaneous plating, also this is a technique principle. Okay, percutaneous plating. اللي هي نحن بدنا نفتح a long incision. Now it's just entry and exit. And then we open through the hole. That's it. نعمل indirect reduction technique. اللي اسمها ميبو يا شباب. ميبو تكنيك. أعتقد تعرفوه. ميبو تكنيك. كويس. Minimal invasive. Percutaneous. Osteosynthesis. اللي هو plating يعني. ميبو تكنيك. اسمها percutaneous plating. نعمل reduction بتاعنا. Then we slide the plate through a minimal incision here and there. And then we're going to have to just to solve the screws. So, Mujahid ya Marjan, the MIPO technique. Highly, واحدة من ميزات الـ locking plate, it will allow you to do this. Okay. Okay, I think this is the last slide. Okay. بعد الكلام اللي قلناه ده كله أتمنى يكونوا استوعبتوه وفهمتوه. If we fail to apply these concepts, what will happen? Definitely one word, failure. 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 Either fracture of the plate, non-union, pull-out screws, and whatsoever. Okay? These are the consequences of such failure. عشان كده التكنيك مهم يا شباب. التكنيك مهم. نحن almost انتهينا. لو في زول عنده سؤال. Any questions so far?
سلام. طيب شكرا جزيلا دكتور أحمد. فرصة للquestions.